Hi, I'm Dr. Sridhar Kalyanasundaram, consultant neonatologist. In this video, we will look into why we need humidity for the premature babies. So, what is humidity? Humidity is water vapor content in the air. And we have relative humidity, which is the percentage of the air which is saturated with water vapor. And we have absolute humidity, which is actually the actual content. So the absolute humidity will increase when the temperature around you increases. So the amount of water vapor can be that can be held in the air at a certain temperature increases as the temperature goes up. So when the environment is hot and the water vapor content is high, it's very humid. And why do we use it in neonatology? So when we have a high relative humidity around the baby's environment, the gradient of the water vapor between the skin surface and the surroundings is reduced. So the chances of a thin skin of the baby losing water vapor by evaporation reduces. So the importance of this comes from thermoregulation principles. Remember that evaporation produces cooling. And if the baby is under a warmer, for example, the heat from the warmer, the radiant heat is going to the baby. But at the same time, because the water vapor from the baby's skin is evaporating, you are losing the temperature by the evaporation as well. So in essence, it's very difficult to manage very preterm baby's temperature by just using a warmer. People started devising different ways to improve the humidity in the baby's environment. The cling film wrap over the radiant warmer was used near the baby's surface. People started using a plexi shield around the baby, and we started devising incubators, which are now commonplace. So the advantage of the incubator that it's a closed space, the heat circulation is by fan of the heated air from the heat coil goes around by fan, and this is by convection. And we have the ability to humidify the atmosphere within the incubator. So we have a humidifying chamber in which we put water, and the heat evaporates this water into water vapor into the incubator canopy. And this increases the relative humidity because it's a closed space, it's protected from the environment. So the relative humidity in the incubator can be as high as 90 to 95%, and when the outside air is not having that high humidity, it's around 50% or so. So the differential when the water vapor comes in contact with the surface of the incubator, which is relatively cooler than the inside of the incubator, which is quite warm for the preterm baby, you get condensation around. So if you go into an NICU and you see an incubator with the walls all misted, that's because they're using a high humidity, and this is typically used in the very preterm baby. So skin is very thin, there is a very high insensible water loss in the first week. The cornification of the skin takes time, after which the humidity can be weaned off. There is another thing that we use in premature babies, especially at the time of delivery, and this is because the baby is coming out from the liker already wet, and you are receiving the baby under a radiant heater. The baby will lose the water vapor very fast, and it's impossible to maintain in a very small baby in the labor room with just a heater. So in the past 20 years or so, we have started using the plastic bag into which the baby is received, and we don't dry these premature babies. The water vapor stays within the bag when you expose the baby to the radiant warmer. So this water evaporating from the skin is used to its advantage. So the closed space within the plastic bag in which the baby is has a very high relative humidity, so there is not much space for the water vapor to evaporate from the baby's skin, so that prevents further heat loss. Is there any disadvantage of the humidification? One disadvantage of the humidification is delayed cornification of the skin, and the longer we continue the humidity, the longer it takes for the maturation of the skin. In fact, there are some units, like the recent presentation we had on my channel from University of Iowa, where they avoid humidifying in the first few days if possible, so the cornification proceeds faster. But of course, most units would not follow that in their routine practice because we're used to humidifying in the small babies in terms of fluid balance and everything. So we have to wean the humidity on a systematic pattern. Once the sodium stabilizes, once the baby's fluid balance is stable, start dropping the humidity. There are guidelines which tell you to drop by 10% a day. But remember that when you drop the humidity, the temperature requirement will go up slightly. So it's easier to titrate it if you drop 5% every 2 days or so the small babies. When you start dropping it, as I said, you can decide based on the fluid balance rather than absolute number of days. If the baby tolerates well, the temperature has come down on the air mode and the sodium is stable on the blood, it's not high anymore, and you're on a reasonable fluid intake, you can start dropping the humidification. The other disadvantage is obviously the risk of infection, and most units now change the water in the humidification chamber every day, and as long as this is done and it's cleaned properly, the risk of Pseudomonas infection and so on is very minimal. We don't face that much these days. So the key things to remember: insensible water loss is high due to the thin skin and the water vapor loss. Evaporation produces cooling, so we need to humidify to increase the relative humidity around, so the evaporative loss is reduced. It makes you better able to maintain the baby's temperature even the baby is very preterm. The more preterm the baby, the longer you need the humidification, the higher the level of humidity that you need as well. In a general basis, we can say that the baby who is less than 30 weeks would need humidity when you start, and the 30 to 32 weekers you can consider humidity if they have a higher requirement for the temperature or any other concerns. And you can start with 90% for the very small babies, extreme preterm babies under 28 weeks, and the 28 to 30 week babies you can start with 80 to 85%. Of course, if the sodium is high in such babies, if the weight loss is significantly more, you can use humidification as a tool to avoid that, and you can modify that and titrate accordingly. As I said earlier about the weaning, you go in gradual steps, and an extreme preterm baby may need humidity for 2 to 3 weeks sometimes, and the 28 to 30 weekers may need for the first week to 10 days. So this is just to give you an overview of humidification in the NICU. I hope it's useful. Please share. Thank you.